Welcome back to our videos. I'm Laurenzio.
And I'm Alessandra.
Twin Flames in Harmony Singing. Students of Jeff and Shalia and Ascension Coaches affiliated with Twin Flame Universe.
And today we are outside. Can you see? We have like, oops, camera. We have a tree behind us. This never happened before on our channel until now. Yes, we are outside. First day, like, we go outside after we kind of like are allowed to go freely, and because of the coronavirus, and we want to talk to you about like a very juicy topic, and it is how to love your twin flame even if you are in separation. And I know that many of you that are on the journey maybe want to kind of send some love to their twin flame, right? And Just care for this person that's so important for you in your life, and how to do that, like how to love them even if you don't know who they are. How can you love them? And the answer to this is quite simple. You just love yourself. You just take good care of yourself, and you give unconditional love to yourself, and you just allow yourself to love fully and completely, just as you are, right? You deserve love. And what happens, like, when this happens? Like, what's the deal here? Like, because you and your twin flame are one consciousness, then when you love yourself, you automatically love them, right? Mm-hmm. And it's really important for you to just practice, you know, self-love, you know. And this is what the mirror exercise is all about, you know. Healing blocks and loving yourself more and more and more, you know?
Yeah.
Because the whole spiel with the mirroring exercise is that you don't feel good, right? And you go through this 4-step process so you can feel better, right?
Mm.
So,
we have some visitors, some cats around here.
Yeah, we have cats, we have birds around. Like, this is not something that's happening usually in our videos, so I hope you enjoy the little bit of wildness and people around. Yeah, we have people, we have everything around us right now, which is interesting. Let's go deeper, shall we? And let's just talk about ourselves a little, like how we did that, you know, when before we were together, like how we loved each other.
Yeah, well, how we did that, it was basically just by loving ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And to give an example, like, I was just, like, I remember I was unhappy, I was just not very comfortable with myself. I was like, okay, what should I do? And, like, I was always, like, so desperate, oh, I need a girlfriend, I need someone to be with, or, like, just that feeling of, like, oh, I need someone in order to feel good. That's just not loving your twin flame unconditionally. That's basically being dependent on of them.
Yeah.
And what I did was just doing something that I enjoy, doing something that I love, and just loving myself. And in this way, like, you are able to just love them unconditionally. So the way you love them unconditionally is just, like, enjoy your life.
Yeah.
Enjoy your life doesn't mean go apart, kind of like go with other people that are not your twin flame in a romantic way.
Yeah, exactly. No, it means to honestly love yourself, right? And it means to practice, you know, self-love in each and every way that feels appropriate to you, right? And really, you know, feel like what's the best way that you can love yourself, right? So again, maybe you know, for example, that, you know, there are some things that negatively affect your life, right? And we don't, even if they might feel good, you know, we don't encourage that. That's not how you love yourself, by doing something that negatively impacts your life so you feel better for a short period of time, right? That's not what we're talking about here. Loving yourself is investing in yourself in an eternal way, right? So even things like, you know, personal studying, you know, something that you love, is investing in yourself. Even, you know, having a very good health care routine or self-care routine is investing and loving yourself, right? Taking care of your mental and spiritual well-being is loving yourself, right? So that's what we're talking about here. We're not talking about numbing out and going, you know, crazy and say like, yeah, I love myself, you know, if I don't, you know, no, that's not, it doesn't mean that you cannot be passionate about you loving yourself, but you know, you have to also think about it a little bit logically, like, am I really loving myself if I'm doing this thing, or I'm just chasing for something temporary that will make me feel good right now, right? So yeah, and this is why it's important for you to maybe know about like the mirror exercise and the teachings of Jeff and Shalia, because yeah, we didn't know how it was to fully and completely love yourself, right?
Yeah.
We knew in some ways, right? And we knew in like things that we should and we shouldn't do. Like we knew you are very intelligent people, I guess. Like you can determine like what's loving and what's not loving in your life. But the truth is that even in our case, like we discovered new ways in which we can go deeper into love every day, right? So don't be shy in you know, claiming support or in, you know, just asking in a way for help if you need so, because the topic of self-love is like very big, and I really love how Jeff and Shalia embody that, right, in their teachings. Like if you were to watch one of their classes, you know, like Twin Flame Ascension School classes, one of their first classes, the first one, let's say, that's free, you can watch it right now. And if you were to watch the last class, you will see how much they grew in love for each other, because they embody this principle of self-love, which of course enables them to go deeper into loving themselves and loving their twin flame more and more, right? So yeah, just spend some time with yourself and just ask yourself what are some ways in which I can love myself more, right? And yeah, as we said, like this is going to be reflected in your twin flame, and your twin flame will feel that in a way connection, heart connection that they have with you, and they will for sure appreciate your love, right? Because true unconditional love is not about just feeling very good right now and then, you know, crashing down a little bit a while later. No, it's really about being sustainable and being like, growing that love, investing in a love, that true love, like, you know, grows and grows and grows into your life. Is not going to end, is not going to fizzle out, it's just going to grow and expand. And this is how the love between you and your twin flame is right now. Maybe you don't know, if you are in separation, you don't know how your twin flame loves you. Well, just invest in loving yourself and you shall see how that love grows.
Yes, and that's beautiful. And just know that if you feel bad, if you feel anything that doesn't feel good, just love yourself and you'll just like get to feel better. And that's practical. It's not just like, oh, let's just say what Jeff and Shia said. No, it's from our experiences. So just love yourself, it's enough. And this way you just love your twin flame unconditionally. Because once you just allow yourself to be loved, to be fully loved and supported right now, you allow your twin flame to relax and to just be themselves.
Yeah, exactly. And I just came into my mind like an example that I can give, like a very kind of day-to-day kind of example that I can give here, is that we talked about that we cook together, right? And we spend a lot of time in the kitchen cooking. Well, we noticed that, you know, we had a shortage of, you know, equipment, you know, in our kitchen when we really started to cook, you know, and not buy food for ourselves, just cook, meaning buy takeout. We noticed that, okay, we didn't have enough like bowls and like pans and everything so we can sustainably cook, right? So what would be the, and we like really tried for a few days, you know, to just and weeks to do our best with what we have, and we managed, you know. It's not like we couldn't cook, right? But surely it was like a little bit uncomfortable sometimes, right? So what would be the most loving thing to do here? Where, of course, for us it meant investing into some kitchen equipment, right? Mm-hmm.
And that can mean for you, like if you're cooking and you're just like in the premise that maybe, let's say, you're not cooking with your twin flame, you're just cooking alone, and you're like, mm-hmm. you're having a struggle-ish time, it would be to invest yourself in cooking equipment for yourself, and this way, yeah. you just improve your experience, and that is a way to love your twin flame condition. Like,
yeah.
whatever you can improve in your life to just for the better for you, that's how you
yeah.
love your twin flame condition.
Because I really love, like, something that I heard from like our friends like Daniel and Diana in one of their videos, and you can check their channel, it's very, very good, is that they feel like if you feel bad right now, why bring another person into the equation, right? You need to be fully and loving towards yourself and have that joy and fulfillment in your life before, you know, you can like bring your twin flame into the equation as well. Otherwise it's just gonna feel bad, you know, with two people, right? And you don't want that. We don't encourage that. We want you to feel very good on your twin flame journey. So therefore, yeah, practice the mirror exercise, love yourself, and yeah, this is our advice for today. No matter if you are in union or in separation, you can do this. It's available for you right now. So hope you do this. Hope you like this video. Subscribe to our channel and see you in the next one.